Welcome back to the Art of Medicine. Let's talk now about the role of arthroscopic surgery in repairing a torn rotator cuff tendon. If we look at our right shoulder again, shoulder blade, socket, and ball, the arm, the bone spurs that are in bone A, and the bone spurs in bone C, and finally the rotator cuff tendon that's inflamed and torn with some separation. And the role of arthroscopic surgery, which will include removing these bone spurs and repairing the tendon. So first of all, through the arthroscope, we bring a little burr in that looks like a little Dremel that removes the spurs. And then we have to repair the tendon. We repair the tendon by first advancing the torn piece so that the ends approximate, then putting some stitches in to hold them together, and then using a device that we call a bone anchor screw. Now, this is a very tiny screw that's literally half the size of the tip of this pen, but I'm going to draw it big so you understand it. Here's the head of the screw. Here is the shaft of the screw. Here are the threads of the screw. And on the head of the screw are attached these little sutures. We bring this screw in through our TV camera and place it into the bone. We then take the stitches and we run them first through this part of the tendon, then through this part of the tendon, and then back onto the screw to reinforce it. So again, what we've done, we have a torn rotator cuff tendon with our bone spurs and the torn tendon. We then have a arthroscopic repair where we've removed the bone spurs on bone A and bone C, and then we've repaired the tendon first by advancing it so that the two ends meet, then by placing an initial suture to hold the ends, and then reinforcing it with what we call a anchor screw. Now, you might ask, what happens if you don't repair it? Can it heal? Well, this will not heal because of a poor blood supply. So in order to try to get it healed, you have to sew it together. Secondly, what if we decide to leave it like it is? Well, there is a progression that occur that can lead to the following. If this rotator cuff is no longer present, eventually, here's your bone spur and bone spurs. This is bone A, bone C. The ball will ride upwards in this manner, coming out of the socket a little and pinching the ball itself, pinching up against the bone spurs because the rotator cuff is not there. Here's one end of it here and one end over here. This will cause the ball to grind into that spur, and the ball will wear out first here, then it'll develop some big spurs here, and then eventually the socket will wear down. So the eventual result of not repairing a tendon can cause this severe arthritis of the ball and socket joint and the possibility of the need for a shoulder replacement in the future.
The surgical treatment of rotator cuff tears has really drastically improved over the last maybe 10 years with the advent of arthroscopic cuff repair. The arthroscope is a small camera that can be inserted into the shoulder through tiny little less than 1 centimeter incisions. Maybe 10, 15 years ago, the treatment for rotator cuff tear involved making a large incision over the side or front of the shoulder here, a very large incision, and to get to the rotator cuff, the surgeon would have to peel off the deltoid muscle to get down to the cuff. That has all changed now with the advent of the arthroscope. Now the cuff can be repaired through tiny little poke holes through this small camera called an arthroscope. And that really has cut down on the amount of pain and the amount of stiffness postoperatively. Patients get back to their daily lives much, much quicker than they did with an open cuff repair.